Judy and I were laughing earlier. He has a funny phrase. It's better to give than to receive. But
sure.
Try telling that to a five-year-old.
Yeah,
right?
On Christmas morning, try to explain to your son how he shouldn't be opening all the presents all at once. It's
right.
Terrible.
The manners just go out the window altogether.
They totally do. But it doesn't have to be that way. Here to help share some important tips to help your children have good manners while they're opening gifts and eating at the table during the holidays is manners expert Elise McVeigh. This is near and dear to me, Elise,
yeah.
Because I am really strict with my son. But when the presents come out, it is a piranha feeding frenzy of wrapping paper and screams. And I would like to find ways to get a little more, I don't know, refinement, manners in the mix. What can I do? What's the number one tip?
A lot of people
have
that same problem with the kids, you know?
I did not let, I have three boys. They're now 12, 10, and 8, and I did not let them open up gifts in front of anyone for a long time because it is, it's very scary. You don't know what they're going to do. And so kids typically give one of three responses that every parent dreads. I already have this. I don't like this. I wanted something else. And so as a parent, you just sit there and think, please don't do that. Please don't do that. And so what you can do is practice. So I have a manners class for kids that I've put thousands of kids through. And one thing that I found that's really successful is doing a lot of role playing. So what I do is I have a box with a gift, and I'll go up to a kid and say, okay, you know, this is a coloring book, but you really wanted an Xbox for Christmas. And so they'll say, okay. And so I'll give it to them, and you know, they'll open it, I'll say, happy holidays, and then they usually say, oh, I wanted an Xbox. I'm like, no, in your head, you're saying that.
So
you're not saying that out loud, and so you do it again, and then they get it, and you just say, thank you. That's what you want to train your child.
We have to do role-playing with them.
Yes.
To get them to
yes.
I'm so unprepared. I'm going to be the worst mother at that point.
But Audra, this is a great life skill to learn what should be said just in your head and what should come out of your mouth. I have a lot of trouble with this particular skill. This is good.
Mommy's learning this at work, but you're also learning it at home too.
No, but it's good. So that helps them with the gratitude, right? With at least the first words out of their mouth is thank you.
And then you have to work on the expression, because you could get a thank you like that. So you really have to, like, have the whole package going. So you have to just practice and practice before you get to the holiday.
My practice would just involve taking the gift away and let them figure out their responses.
Yeah.
They'd figure it out after a while, wouldn't they?
They would, but you might be horrified of who they do it in front of before you get to that point.
So what about when they do go to someone's house? You know, you've got some kids that will show up at the door with the parents. The kids bust through the door, and they run upstairs. They run inside the house. You've got some tips to keep the kids from doing all that.
Yes. Once again, go back to role-playing. And I always give my children a little pep talk in the car before we even get to the door. At this point, they're old enough, but when they're really young, we would, you know, we'd be in front of the house, and I'd say, all right, you know, we're meeting Dr. So-and-so and Mrs. So-and-so, or, you know, whatever their titles are. We'd go over the whole meeting and greeting, shaking hands, you know, having good eye contact. Then I'd say, okay, ring the doorbell once, and then you need to let them invite you and tell you where to go. Because you don't just run through someone's house. I don't care if you've been there 20 times. You don't go up to Timmy's room to go play with his trucks. You wait until he says, let's go upstairs.
And then once they're inside, you teach them how to sit correctly in someone's house.
Yes,
right?
Exactly. And I tell them, don't put your feet up on the furniture. You know, don't get too comfortable, even if your friend is. Don't go into someone's pantry or refrigerator. Young kids, well, actually older kids, I've heard do that too.
It sounds like this practicing, this modeling the behavior and practicing and talking about it in advance is really the key to getting them to deliver in the moment.
It is. And it sounds silly at first to do the whole role-playing thing, and it's something my dad used to make me do. For example, he'd go over eye contact with me all the time, and the shaking hands. I got to a job interview when I was in my young 20s, and the interviewer actually said, you have the best eye contact I've ever seen. So since then, I've been sold on the idea, and it really does work. It's very effective.
Okay.
Great.
So here we go. I'm going to add that to my list of things to figure
out. Eye contact, shake hands, just the practice.
And patience. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Elise.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.
Okay, you can find all of these tips and lots more on her new DVD. It's called Mrs. McVeigh's Magnificent Manners Show. I like that title.
I do, too.